Let me share with you another story of surprising joy. We are finding an encouraging trend throughout our mission dioceses. Vocations to the priesthood are growing significantly. This news certainly brings great joy. But what many people do not know is that each individual diocese is responsible for the financial support of their seminarians, their training and formation for the priesthood. While increasing interest in the priesthood is a tremendous blessing, it also creates a unique funding burden. Even an increase of a few seminarians in a diocese amounts to hundreds of thousands of dollars in additional financial responsibility. In this past year, Catholic Extension has provided almost $4 million to support seminarians. Father Robert Barron, rector of Mundelein Seminary, is here to discuss with us the importance of this funding and the task he has with these young men and their formation. Father Barron, thank you for having us here at beautiful Mundelein Seminary.
It's my great pleasure to be with you.
You know, Bob, it seems that only yesterday that we just met. You were an aspiring seminarian, and I was a vocation director, and now you're heading one of the outstanding seminaries in the United States.
Yeah, well, thank you. You were my way into the church in many ways. As you say, I met you when I was just a college student, and you were the door that led into seminary, then the priesthood, and where I am today.
And here we are.
Here we are.
Well, Father Barron, as you know, Catholic Extension is providing funding for approximately 600 seminarians across the United States. 30 of them are here at Mundelein Seminary. How important is it for the future of the church in the United States that Catholic Extension and our donors be invested in supporting seminary education?
Well, it's indispensably important, and I can't really imagine a better way to invest in the future of the church than to invest in the formation of seminarians. Look, if you're forming a future priest, you're forming somebody who's now going to influence the church in a massive way over the next, let's say, 50 years. Think of all the preaching and teaching, evangelizing, work with the poor, visiting of sick, visiting hospitals. Think of all the ways that a single priest radiates the grace of God outward. Multiply that now over 50 years, multiply that by the 600 priests that you're forming. That's a massive impact on the life of the church. And I can't imagine a better way to affect the future of the church positively than to invest in a seminarian.
Well, we're very proud of our work here and very excited that we can serve the seminarians here at Mundelein as well. You have that special task of cultivating heartfelt missionary zeal in men studying to become priests. How are you going about doing that?
Well, you know, I'll say first, Extension has shown the way. You know, go back to the immigrant period in the big cities. You could assume that Catholics would come to our institutions to be evangelized. They come to parishes, schools, seminaries. We could count on that. Of course, now we can count on it. 75% of Catholics don't come to Mass. The largest growing group in America religiously are the nuns, N-O-N-E-S, those who have no religion. The second largest religion in America, if you counted it as a religion, would be ex-Catholics. The point is, we can't assume people will come to our institutions. Therefore, we have to do what you've always done. You've always had a missionary sensibility of going out and evangelizing. Now, that's true across the church. So I tell these guys, you can't simply think about the parish priesthood as maintaining the life of a parish. You can't simply care for those who come, as important as that will always be. Every priest in every parish in Chicago or anywhere else has to see himself as a missionary. That is the summons of our time. And I remind the students all the time that when they leave this place, they enter mission territory, wherever they are. See, you've shown the way. Extension has shown us how to do this. Now we have to do it everywhere. That's exactly what Pope Francis understands.
Well, Father Barron, thank you on behalf of all of us, really, for the work that you're doing to form the future priesthood in the United States. It's been a wonderful time to share this moment with you, and thank you for all that you're doing for us.